Hey, then it might. The space around your body is a space for possible actions, right? I can take a sip, catch a ball, or jump on this table. Or can I? What I can and what I can't. Let's talk about affordances. What are affordances? A cup, a loose drinking, but usually only to its owner. A paddle, afford drinking, but mostly for animals. A little branch, a loose support, but only for ant-sized animals. These are examples of affordances. Affordances are subjectively perceived opportunities for actions, given your body schema, trained movements, or general context. Remember, we talked that mind is not only embodied, extended, and inactive, but also embedded in your history, desires, intentions, and plans. You perceive affordances, given all these factors. For different organisms, the same tree can provide support, shade, fruit, wood, home. Each organism sees its own subjective environment filled with affordances that it can act upon. So an environment is a collection of affordances. When you think about it, you may notice that organisms often create environments for each other. For example, group hunters have their preferred roles. Ants cultivate mushrooms. A lichen is actually a collection of three or four different organisms. An individual organism lives in a close relationship with other organisms. For cognitively advanced beings, this makes even more sense. For example, siblings create environment for each other. In a way, every organism is an organism-environment system, where in this environment are different organisms. This organism-environment system is underpinned with affordances. The term affordances was developed around 50 years ago by James Gibson. This influential thinker realized that visual information is subjectively processed in search of possible actions. Since then, affordances have been reused in many disciplines. In a sense, perception of affordances reflect what one can do in its environment. But what the environment is? Gibson understood environment physically, in terms of the biomechanics of the body schema. Since then, however, affordances have been adopted by cognitive scientists, who added this cognitive layer of understanding. Therefore, today, affordances broadly refer to subjectively perceived opportunities for action in any environment. Scientists argue how to precisely operationalize this term, but we will not go so far here today. Today, we will notice that environment can be biomechanical or psychocognitive. In either case, environment is a set of affordances. One interesting view on affordances is presented by Anthony Chamorro, who understands affordances as dynamic relations between an organism's capacities to act and features of its environment. Action, in a way, is following relations, following affordances. In summary, affordances are dynamic relations between an organism and its environment. Environment is often filled with different organisms. It can be physical, social, or even virtual. In any case, environment is subjective to an organism acting in it, and actions are actually perceiving and following affordances. This means that humans exist in multiple environments. Physical environments of our bodies, social environments of our conspecifics, business environments of our economies. You act in these environments by noticing and following affordances that it provides. This, in turn, change your 4E mind in a way that your new mind will perceive new affordances and develop itself further as an organism environment system. I wish you a fruitful development. Cheers.